Our objective in this series is to demonstrate how we can edit data using MVC. We have already learned how to create new records. The purpose is now to edit an existing record. So most of the concepts are going to be same, but we'll still go through the whole process. And let us see how do we do it. And one more thing, we'll be doing it in two ways. First, we'll be doing entirely without AJAX, and secondly, we'll be showing how to do the same thing with AJAX. Then we'll be extending this for AJAX. The same project will be extended for AJAX so that you can see the various features how they'll be done with AJAX. To start with, we already have created a database under app underscore data, dborders.sdf. That is the only thing which we have added first. Otherwise, this is the same basic MVC application. So before proceeding, let us have a look at what are the tables and columns inside this database. So go to Database Explorer. It consists of a table called TBL orders, having a primary key ID, product code, foreign key, order number, amount, and there is a second table that is called TBL product space. We can have a look at the data, then we'll understand it better. Show table, first of all, you can see what are the columns, various columns, in case you want to create your own database. So this is TBL products base. The name of the table is TBL products base, and product code is the column name, prod code ncar1. This is the primary key, prod name nvarchar50. So this is the structure of the table called TBL products base. And let us have a look at the data that is already there. So it consists of these records, product code L for laptop, M for mobile, and S for software. So there are three types of products that are maintained by the company, and orders are issued for these. And coming to TBL orders, show table data. Before showing, okay, you can see the table data first. This is a running ID. Product code foreign key comes from the other table. M, S, M, those codes are coming here. Then we have an order number. And then we have an order amount. So we have to basically, we have deliberately created a foreign key relationship so that we can see how to work with editing in these complex scenarios also. And let us see the structure of this table in case you want to do it yourself. So here it is. The name is TBL orders. This ID is identity. So auto numbered. Prod code foreign keys NCAR1. Data type must match with that one in the other table. Order number is NVARCHAR100 and amount is INT4. So this is our database. And let us now proceed to add the entity to it. So this is our Solution Explorer. We'll pin it. Add a folder called Entity Models. Right click it. Add new item. And from data, we can pick ADO.NET entity data model, and we can write mod orders and click add. Generate from database. Yes, next. This is the database. Click next. tick mark this one so that all the tables come. Pluralize or singularize, include foreign key, finish. So this is what we have at the moment, and this relation is auto generated. We forgot to show you the other thing from where we got these relationships. Here we'll come back to our tables, and on TBL orders you should right click to add table properties, and here you will find add relations. You should have already added before going for the entity addition. These relations should have already been added, and this is add manage relations, because I have already added it, appears under manage. Otherwise you will go to add relations and give it a name here. So rel fk, primary key is TBL product space, foreign key is TBL orders, cascade, and column is prod code and prod code fk. So this relation was already added. In one of the videos it has been shown how to add the relations. You can refer to that video. And this is the entity model that has been generated for us. Closing it, saving it, and this is my solution explorer. So this is my model that has been added by the framework. So now to begin with, now what we'll basically need is, we'll first have to display the orders in a tabular form somehow. We have to display the orders, and against each order there will be an edit hyperlink. So when the user clicks this edit hyperlink, here is, let us say, order number 056 and amount is 2000 and so on. When the user clicks on this edit, he should be taken to a new page where he'll be displayed a data entry form which is already containing values 056, 2000 and all those values. And on that there should be a save button, and the moment the user clicks this save button, the data should be updated. In case it is okay, and then we'll come back to the same page, and here the altered data should be shown to the user. So this is one scenario where AJAX is not used. If we use AJAX, then what would happen is, click on edit, a dialog would pop up, the same data entry form that was shown on the other page will be shown here, and a save button would be there, and when he clicks the save, this pop-up vanishes and the updated data is shown here. So we'll show both the scenarios, but right now we are showing the scenario where an edit button appears and the user is taken to a new page. So the objective of the current lecture is to merely display this story. Let us see how to do it. To begin with, the minimum thing we have to do is add a controller. Add controller, give it to home, and also add an index action, add view index. Strongly typed, we will worry about it later, or we can add. I usually favor adding it by hand there only. So click add. So this is the view you get corresponding to that action, and here we'll have to add the line that add the rate small model and all. So before going to that, let us now see what we are to actually display here. So we'll display a table like this. Here the first column should display the name of type of the product, that is complete name, software, mobile. The complete name should appear here. The second thing is the order number, and then amount, and finally an edit hyperlink. So this is what we plan to display here. So for this, first of all, we have to make arrangements for the data. And then we'll come back to this page to write the code for the table. So we go back to our home controller and start to bring data. Using DB, so we have to actually, so this is the namespace that we'll have to append it here, prepend it here, dot TBL DB order entities. So what we'll do is we'll just write at the top using entity models. So this will save a lot of typing here, and we can write, is it okay? Something is still wrong. So I have to put it here using editing data underscore no ajax dot. So I have to write the full path to the namespace there. Ctxt is equal to new, and here I can write this story. So now what I have to bring is, I can write where that is equal to ctxt dot tpl orders. Now I want actually not the codes for the product, software S and all, I want the complete name also. So this means my TBL orders that comes, it should contain the data for TBL products also, TBL product codes also. So this is the database, products base, sorry. TBL orders should not alone come, but it should bring the related data of TBL product space. If we have a look at this diagram, then with each order a TBL products base object is attached, which, from which we can reach the name of the product. So what we have to do is, we are not to bring alone TBL orders, but we are also to bring the data for TBL products base. So how do we do that? For this we have to write include and the name of the table for which we want the data. The table must be related. So it is TBL products base. So I'll write TBL products base, and then I can execute the query right now and get the list out of it and pass that list to my view. So this is the code that we are writing for the index action. ctxt.tblorders.includeTBLProductsBase.toList. If we do not include this line, then you will be able to get TBL orders on the view, but you won't be able to reach the actual name of the product. Since TBL orders will contain only the code, we are not interested in displaying the code, we are interested in displaying the entire name of the product. So you have to use this include here. This query does become a little heavy, but this is one of the ways in which you can get data. And especially if the amount of data that will be queried is small, then this is perfectly okay. But in case you feel that it is going to give rise to a very like complicated scenario, very heavy query, then you can consider using the join and all, and they will give you the combined result already there. So joins would work in that case. So if you want to get the complete data, one is to use the parent table, the child table, perform a join, and return a new table that consists of this name column from this table and the remaining two columns from here. So that would be possible by using a join. But a shortcut is also possible, dot include TBL orders base. So this works if the amount of data involved is small and the query won't be tough. So this is I wanted to demonstrate to you. So okay, with this also we'll see how things work. Coming back to our CSHTML, we'll have to write the @ small model here. So we can write it quickly. Since we are getting a TBL order, a TBL order list, we have written IEnumerable. Now we can begin to generate the table. So table border is 1. We can quickly type it off. So product, number, amount, edit. Then after the T head row, TR. So here you can see that we have obtained it like this. @ v dot tbl product space dot product name. Since tbl product space has been brought here with the include from the previous page, and putting a prod name will give me the name of the product. The remaining is same order number amount, but this one could be new for you. Action link. This is one way of doing the things. Action link edit. This is the display that will appear. And edit record is the name of the action that we'll add very soon there. And the data passed to that action would be v.id. So from there we'll be able to retrieve which id is to be edited. So you'll be able to pass. So you'll be able to pass id to that view, to that action. Action link has three parameters. One is the display text. The other is the action that is ultimately to be called if it is inside the current controller. Otherwise, there is another overload available where you can specify the name of the controller also. And this is the root data. That is the parameters of the edit record action. There we might write edit record bracket int question mark id. So this id will reach there, and then we can do our editing process, whatever we want to do on that id. This is one way of generating the hyperlink. The other would have been that we could have written the usual method href is equal to, then we would have written home slash edit record slash @ v.id. So that is also possible. The same thing would have been done there also. @ v, in case you are not clear, I can write it on a separate page. A href is equal to, so you can write something like @ string dot format, and here double quotes slash home slash edit record slash 0 comma @ v dot id. This single quote closes, and this one closes here, and then here you can write edit and close the edit here. Actually, when you write @ html dot action link, then the same story is actually generated by the MVC for you. That is a shortcut if you want. But in a couple of projects I have found that this one is always very handy as compared to that. Some issues do crop up when you try to use that built-in one. So in case you find yourself in a problem, then you can definitely revert back to the traditional method of generating the hyperlink yourself. So this is what we have. Our table is completed, and now let us try to run it and see what the output is. So this is what you see: mobile, the names are there now, order number, amount. Now if you click on this, we'll get error because we haven't added anything, but these added boxes appear. And if I click on this one, it will definitely take me to error point. Home by, added record by 1. So ID must have been 1 in that case. If I click this one, by 4. And if I view the source, let me show you what we get there. It is the same thing it has been generated for us. href is slash home slash added record slash 3. So you could have used @html.actionlink or maybe formatted it yourself. So this closes this one, and then in the next lecture we'll proceed how to handle this click.